Bora Bora is a volcanic island in the Society Islands archipelago of French Polynesia. The Polynesian island in the South Pacific is ranked at the top of the list when it comes to most remarkably beautiful in the world. The best time to travel is in May. It is perfectly possible to spoil yourself in one of the incredibly luxurious high-class resorts and spend the savings of a lifetime in a few days. Nonetheless, a bit of planning ahead can allow enjoyment of the majestic scenery with a tighter budget. Bora Bora is a very pricey destination. Everything, catering and activities, ranges from expensive to indescribably expensive. Bora Bora is an island in the leeward group of the Society Islands of French Polynesia. The island, which is about 230 kilometers, 140 miles, northwest of Papeete, is surrounded by a lagoon and a barrier reef. In the center of the island are the remnants of an extinct volcano rising to two peaks, Mount Paya and Mount Etmeno, the highest point at 727 m, 2,385 feet. The original name of the island in the Tahitian language might be better rendered as Pora Pora, meaning firstborn, an early transcription found in 18th and 19th century accounts, is Bolabala or Balabala. The major settlement, Baytape, is on the western side of the island, opposite the main channel into the lagoon. The products of the island are mostly limited to what can be obtained from the sea and coconut trees, which were historically of economic importance for copra. During the 2017 census, the population on the island was about 10,600 people, up from 8,880 in 2007. The history of Bora Bora shows that the island's first settlers back in the 4th century were Tongan people. The first European explorers who visited the island were led by James Cook. However, prior to this, island of Bora Bora was already sighted by other explorers. In 1842, the island became a French colony under the governance of Admiral Abel Aubert de Petite Thouars. During World War II, the United States made Bora Bora a base for military supply, oil depot, airstrip, and seaplane base. They constructed defensive fortifications around the island. Luckily though, no combat took place here and the presence of American troops seemed to be accepted by the opposition forces. The United States military base closed in 1946, following the end of the war. However, many Americans decided to stay on the island as it had become close to their hearts. Some Americans were even forcibly asked to leave following complaints from their families on the mainland. The abandoned base became French Polynesia's only international airport until FAA International Airport opened in the 1962 in Papeete, Tahiti. Bora Bora now relies largely on tourism, and because of this, seven luxurious resorts were built over the past few years. Hotel Bora Bora was the first to build bungalows that stand over the water using stilts. These are now a given of every resort on the island, as these bungalows provide spectacular sights of lagoons and mountains. The climate in Bora Bora and the surrounding islands is considered to be tropical. Unlike most places, the seasons can be divided into two seasons, the wet season and the dry season. The wet season, Polynesian summers, runs from November till April with an average rainfall of 3-4 THS of the yearly precipitation. During these times, the humidity levels can be at an all-time high. The storms during these months are frequent and unpredictable. The rainfall is about 1,800 millimeters or 71 inches. And the weather is 30 degrees Celsius or 86 degrees Fahrenheit. The dry season running from May to October, this is when tourism is at its peak on the island. During these months, the temperature is a few degrees lower and rain is rare. The best time weather-wise with the least risk of storms is in the winter months. The very best part about the weather in Bora Bora is that the water temperature hovers around 30 degrees Celsius on average. However, during this high tourist season, May, October, tourist prices skyrocket and there are many more people around. The main languages that are spoken by people in Bora Bora Island are French and Tahitian, although most inhabitants that interact with visitors have good comprehension of the English language. Most tourists that visit the island are Americans, Japanese, and Europeans. Small island formed by coral and sand, Motu. There are about 10,600 people living in Bora Bora. These people have a firm grip on the culture, myths, and traditions that have been handed down from the Polynesian gods. They have traditional songs and dances for the island. They love to share their culture with the visitors. The pace is laid back with a relaxing atmosphere. They live by a philosophy ATPP, which means not to worry. The main languages that are spoken in Bora Bora are French and Tahitian. English is also spoken in many hotels, resorts, markets, and tourist locations. The island of Bora Bora is a volcanic caldera. This geography has produced a lagoon, well protected from waters by the surrounding motus, islets. The lagoon and the tropical underwater life, including sharks and rays, provide fantastic opportunities for many forms of water-based recreation, ranging from swimming, through snorkeling and to scuba and other options if you truly want to immerse yourself in this unique environment. In addition to the sights under the surface of the lagoon, the dominating and unusually shaped peak of Mount Atmano, which reaches 728 meters above sea level, and its smaller neighbor Mount Paya are also worthy attractions. The combination of the beautiful lagoon and these impressive peaks provide an almost endless supply of opportunities to take travel photos, which will leave your friend back home cursing you for sharing them. Very few go to Bora Bora for the historic relics. However, if you have seen enough of the lagoon, you might want to take a peek at the few World War II remains and the archaeological Polynesian relics in one of the tours of the island. 1. Bora Bora Lagoonarium. A certified diver acts as underwater guide as you swim and come face to face with the turtles, sharks, stingrays, and numerous other fish which call the Lagoonarium their home. As the Rium name implies, this commercial aquarium is a captive, enclosed zoo-like environment, preventing free movement beyond the confines of the establishment. For those that are not into diving, there is a little submarine. Numerous travelers that have voted this as an all-time favorite. The island is about 32 km, 20 miles, around, and bikes and small cars are available for rent at various sites. It is well worth the investment to ride the perimeter of the island. The jeep tours are well worth a trip. You'll have a good time climbing through some rough trails on the island, and you'll get some breathtaking views. In addition, you'll tour the American World War II ruins, such as gun emplacements and bunkers. It is possible to access the summit of Mt. Paya by foot, although neither the staff at City Hall nor the gendarmerie will tell you how if you do not have a guide, as even adept hikers have gotten lost or been injured. To access the trailhead, head 100 m, 330 feet, north of the cross street into Vaitape Harbor. There will be an arcade of shops to your right. Look for a dirt road between the antique dealer and snack toward the north end of the arcade. Head up the dirt road about 150 meter, 465 feet, and look for a small grass field on your left that is just before the last house on the drive. It is wise to ask the owner for passage, as you must traverse privately owned property to access the trail, which will initially appear faint but become more defined after the first 10 meter, 33 feet. Continue along the trail until you reach a fork, which will have two other trails heading north and south, through a plantation and an open field, respectively, and the main trail up to the top due east. Make sure you are well provisioned, as the 600 meter elevation gain takes place over a relatively short distance, and be sure to identify the trees or rocks with white-red-white striping that will show you the way. Some of the latter sections can be precarious, so make sure you keep your grip and be courteous to those who may be downstream of falling rocks unintentionally loosed by your foothold. The rope climb at the end is exciting. If you want more, head south along the uncommonly traveled trail for spectacular views.